Dear students, welcome to online classes of SVGMS Nimbahera. Dear students, as you know, childhood is the best part of human life because a person does not have any type of worries, any type of frustration, disappointment during his or her childhood. Childhood is also known for its innocence, and during childhood, all the people remain carefree and cheerful. All the people miss childhood in later parts of their life. Everybody misses childhood for its innocence, and children tend to follow the advice of others without thinking too much because they are very innocent. One poet of English, Marcus Nathan, has written a beautiful poem on childhood. Today I am going to teach that poem to you. The first stanza has been written on the board for you. When did my childhood go? Was it the day I ceased to be 11? When did my childhood go? In the first line, the poet asks, when did he lose his childhood? Where did his childhood come to an end? The poet asks in the first line of the stanza, when did my childhood go? Was it the day I ceased to be 11? He further asks, was it the day when he became 11 years of age, or when he became 12 years, or became teenager? Was it the time I realized that hell and heaven could not be found in geography? And he further asks, he lost his childhood when he realized that heaven and hell are two imaginary things, and they do not exist on the earth, on the planet of earth. He feels that it was the end of his childhood, and therefore could not be, was that the day? And he asked the question, was it the day when he grew up, when he became a teenager, and we came to realize that heaven and hell are only imaginary things and they do not exist on earth? So in the first stanza, he asked the two questions about childhood, about the ending of childhood. First, when did he lose his childhood? And he himself answers the question, was it the day when he became 11 years of age? And was it the day when he came to realize that heaven and hell are imaginary things and they did not exist, and they do not exist on the earth? So dear students, for comprehension questions of stanza first, I am going to give you some questions. So write down them in your copy. Comprehension questions. Who wrote this poem? Which part of life, which part of life has the poem been written? Third question is, of the poet come to an end? Fourth question is, what thing did the poet realize about heaven and hell? These are four questions of stanza number first. First question is, who wrote this poem? The answer is very simple. Marcus Natan has written this poem. And he is the poet of this poem. The second question is, which part of life has the poem been written about? The poem has been written about childhood. The main theme of the poem is childhood. You can write the answer like this. When did the childhood of the poet come to an end? If you go through the first stanza, you will come to this answer. You will get the answer. When he became the 11 years old, he realized that his childhood had come to an end. The third question is, the fourth question is, what thing did the poet realize about heaven and hell? The poet realized about heaven and hell that they are imaginary places and they do not exist on the earth. There is no place on the earth there he did not find when he grew up on the earth. They are just imaginary places. And they do not found. No one can find heaven and hell on the geography, on the surface of the earth. So the poet realizes that when he realizes that heaven and hell are only imaginary things, and he realizes that his childhood has come to an end. Now I am going to teach you the second stanza. When did my childhood go? In the second stanza, the poet once again asks the same question. When did my childhood go? Was it the time I realized that adults were not all that they seemed to be? The poet says that adults and grown-up people say one thing at one time and they do the different thing, and there is no one-to-one relationship between their words and their action. So there is, the poet says the adults are hypocrites. They perform their duties with great hypocrisy. Was it the time I realized that adults were not all they seem to be? Adults say one thing and do the opposite thing. They talked of love and preached of love. The poet further says that adult used to tell him about the value of love in life, and they give him sermons. They used to give him the teaching of love, but actually they hate others. When he completed his childhood, he realized that adults or grown-up people usually hated others or usually hate others, but did not act so lovingly. So he did not find a one-to-one relationship between the action and words of the grown-up people. They tell one thing and they do the opposite thing. So the poet realizes, was that the day? And he further says, was the day when he realizes the actual action of the people, grown-up people, and he does not find one-to-one relationship between their words. So he wants to say that adults are hypocrites. They do not perform their works, they do not love others, but they preach too much about love and affection. So dear students, I'm going to give you some questions on this second stanza. Question of second stanza. What question Does the poet again asks, what does the poet discover in the behavior of adults? Third question is, does the poet like the behavior of the grown-up people? These are three questions of stanza number 2. First question is, what question does the poet again ask? The poet has again asked about the ending of his childhood. He asks, where his childhood has go? Where did my childhood go? This is the answer. The second question is, what does the poet discover in the behavior of adults? He discovers that adults say one thing and do the opposite thing. So there is no one-to-one relationship between the words and behavior and performance or action of the adults. They preach love, but they do not love others. And there is no one-to-one the relationship between words and action of the adults. That's why he does not like them. He calls them hypocrites. Does the poet like the behavior of grown-up? No, the poet does not like the behavior of grown-up people. Now we should move to the third stanza. The third stanza, was that the day dear friends, follow me. When did my childhood go? Was it when I found my mind was really mine? It means the poet wants to say, when he started thinking independently, he found that his childhood was over. He found that his childhood came to an end. To use whichever way I choose. Or when he realized that he can take his own, that he could take his own path of life, was it the day when his childhood came to an end? To use whichever way I choose, producing thoughts that were not those of other people. And he said that, was it the day when he started thinking independently and when he started to follow his own thoughts without giving attention to the thoughts of others? In this stanza, the poet advocated the independent thinking of himself, but my own and mine alone. He says that, was it the day when he started thinking independently and his childhood got over? Why that the day? And he further asked the same question. Was it the day when his childhood got over, when he started thinking independently, when he started to give thoughts to his own life? So, dear students, I am going to some questions based on the stringent number 3. First question is, do the children follow the views and ideas of others . Did the poet follow the thoughts of others? The thoughts of others? Keep the thoughts of others? Others, when his childhood, came to an end. After childhood, what did the poet start to do? So these are 3 questions instead of stringent number 3. Now look at the questions. Do the children follow the views and ideas of others? Yes, the children blindly follow the views and ideas of others. Second question is, did the poet keep the thoughts of others when his childhood came to an end? No, the poet did not keep the thoughts of others. He started thinking independently and he started to choose his own way of life. After childhood, what did the poet start to do? After childhood, the poet started to have his own thoughts. He did not follow the thoughts of others and he started to think independently. So these are the 3 stanzas. Now the 4th stanza and final stanza of the poem. Stanza number 4. This is a concluding stanza of this poem. Where did my childhood go? The poet again asked the same question. When did he lose his childhood? Or when his childhood came to an end? It was to some forgotten places. Or he further says, perhaps in some forgotten places his childhood had gone. That's hidden in an infant's face. And he says that perhaps his childhood can be seen in the face of a small baby because small baby tend to have, small babies tend to have innocence, and small babies known for their innocence. That's all I know. And in the final line, the poet says that he knows all this thing about childhood. That's why he says so. So dear friends, I'm again going to give you some questions based on the stanza number 4. First question is, where did the childhood of the poet go? Second question is, where can the childhood be found? Third question is, what do you mean by infant? So these are three questions of stanza number 4 and final stanza. Where did the childhood of the poet go? The childhood of the poet went to some unforgotten places, some unknown places. The childhood of the poet went to unknown or forgotten places. Where can the childhood be found? The childhood can be found in the face of an infant, in the face of a small baby. What do you mean by infant? Infant means a small baby below the age of 3. That is known as childhood. That is known as infant. Now, dear friends, I'm going to tell you the message of this poem, and I want to write the message of the poem on the board, and the message can be used in different types of answers of the lesson of the poem. You can use this in lines for answering many questions of the lesson. The message of the poem. In the poem, the poet describes various qualities of a small child. He describes that innocence is the main quality of childhood. Main quality of childhood. The small children follow whatever they are advised they are very innocent so this is the main message of the poem dear friends you will have to solve and write down the answers of all the questions given in the textbook and learn the lesson completely from examination's point of view the lesson is very important and thank you for being with me on online